Hey folks, did you see that video that I did earlier today talking about the garbage problem outside of the Post thrift store? People have been breaking into them and doing all kinds of terrible things, taking the stuff, maybe even sleeping and living in these things. It's a little bit of a two-pronged problem. You know, sometimes it has to do with people making donations at the wrong times. Sometimes it has to do with people breaking into those storage containers there where the donations normally go. Well, I received a reply here from the Post thrift store or in the comment section of my Facebook, and I wanted to read that out for you guys so that you had all of the information directly from the source here. So it says, "Thomas, thanks so much for bringing awareness to the issues that we face here on a daily basis. Through the generous donations from local businesses and a service club, we have recently added an up-to-date security system." Here's my commentary on that. That means they're going to be able to catch people that are dumping stuff in the middle of the night. So they'll probably be getting some license plates on the security cameras and whatnot. And it says, "We are in the process of updating the donation bins, but vandalism that we are experiencing is on the increase. We have attempted to reinforce portions of the bins, but as you can see, a single door has been completely removed by someone. Some simple ideas for donating to prevent your valuable items from being wrecked by the weather or prevented from entering the store. Number one, bring your items down to the post during operating hours." That's the best one. Just bring your stuff down while there's somebody there. If you can't personally do it, maybe, pay somebody a few dollars. We'll get some gas money and get them to bring it down during business hours, because it's way better if it can get inside the store. Number two, if you have large items, call ahead as they have limited space for desks and couches. Number three, consider if you would truly use the item that you were donating. Anything that requires significant repair, cleaning, or has a cost that has a cost increase in reselling and thus makes the item more expensive to resell. Number four, what the post does not take as donations, mattresses, major appliances, infant furniture, the large box CRT TVs, leaving those items only increases our expenses in waste or recycling. Ready will take the TVs, and Restore Habitat for Humanity will take the appliances. Please consider the other resources in Medicine Hat before you simply choose to leave items in a single location for the sake of convenience. Thanks again for all you do to support the Post and the promotion of mental health awareness in our community." Well, the folks at the Post, you are very, very welcome, and I am proud to be able to support you guys, and I want to do whatever I can, whether it be donating to you guys or going there to purchase things. Hey, I'm just looking down my coat right here, and I got actually something I'll grab. I was down at the Post earlier today and found myself for $1, found some Samsung original headphones, a charging cable, and a charge box. I mean, how many people out there with a Samsung cell phone, how many times have you got, "Oh my God, I don't have my charger. Damn it, I gotta go buy a charger. Darn it, I lost my headphone." Do you got one of those bricks to plug in with? Do you got one of them? And probably spend $20, $30 on a combo like this. I got it for $1 down at the Post. So there's my example of why the Post is great and you should spend your money there. Go check out the store if you've never been there before. Earlier today, actually, I found a really interesting wig there. And if you've watched all 3 minutes and 30 seconds of this video, then you deserve to see the clip of the wig that I found there and what I thought was funny about it. Cue the clip.
Excuse me, can I talk to the manager, please?